putting a small extrusion, you want to use a smaller amount of clay, you don't want to clean up the big guy, we do have this small handheld extruder, caulking gun really, that we can use. And we've got several different types of dies. So I've got some flat dies, there's these plasticky ones, different shapes. Some of them are kind of interesting, some of them are just tubes, or I mean just coils. But we have this dog-shaped one that I'm going to use today, sort of a strange die there. Those are all kept in this little container over in the bottom extruder drawer. We've also got some hollow dies, and these come in a whole bunch of different shapes, a whole bunch of different inside shapes and outside shapes, and a few different sizes of some of them. So I've got a square one set up right here, and what's going to happen is you're going to line up your two dies, get your finger out of the way, and you'll be able to see what's going on. But I'm going to put this on the outside, and then this middle one goes on the inside. I can unscrew, this is our spider, I can unscrew this little tiny screw and screw it back in, or bolt, or whatever we want to call this thing. This just screws right in here, that goes on the outside. You'll put these things together on one end of the extruder, and then this thing screws on. Make sure you align that right, because right now I have a diamond inside a square, and that's going to rip my edges. So I've got that straightened out. As you start to extrude, I would double check and just make sure those things are lined up. As soon as you've got pressure of clay coming through there, it's going to be harder to fix. But I've done a hollow one. The process is pretty similar. I want to show you this kind of funny one here. So I'm going to stick this extruder die in here, screw this on, and then I'll have to orient it again. These are a bit small, so getting them lined up can be a bit tricky. Let's see if I can do this. All right, I'm going to hold it right side up so it doesn't fall down. And then I'm going to screw this on straight like that. Now I've got some pressure orienting my dog. I'm cutting off part of his face. So I'm going to reset him and then redo him. There. Let's stop this.